Hi guys, it's Burb here and welcome to today's exclusivity report. Today, I'm going to go for a couple of timeframes of Bitcoin USD spot price on Coinbase exchange. Some of you may know that I've been feeling, you know, not fully healthy or long story short, sick for the past couple of days ever since the last week, but I'm feeling much, much better already. There's only like nasal noise perhaps that is left, so excuse this for the video. This is something that you probably need to bear. So to start with, well, we have seen some sort of trend change or change in the direction of the market, right? There has been clean declining tendency, as in, the high was made, then the low was actually made with some sort of like a, if you will, double top pattern, but it's obvious only in the hindsight. Then it was followed by sideways with a break through, break beneath, break down another ranging environment, right? So it is range, trend, local trend, and another range, right? So we can tell that most of the time we are actually ranging. This is coming from the fact of us ranging on the major timeframes, right? So whatever larger timeframes we apply, be it weekly or even if you look at weekly, right, we've been moving for more than a year almost in this entire range box, this range bound movement, okay? Something that I, as you may happen to know, would dare call a reaccumulation, okay? For many reasons, right or wrong, it is sideways. The market is not trending on the major scale, the major time frame, okay, the major time scope, and this sets the overall indecision and lack of directional narrative on the lower time frames, right? So whatever happens on the higher time frames is always the dominant narrative and the dominant tendency on the lower time frames, right? So this defines the overall indecision. If you go to lower time frames, well, we were moving sideways here for most of the time, then we kind of like broke down, but we eventually ended up invalidating the floor of the sideways, not necessarily respected well anymore, as in, you know, people would expect the breakdown and then literal crash down to like perhaps immediate 30,000s or 20,000s or even 10,000s, as I said. But it didn't happen, right? So instead, the market seems to be, you know, ranging just kind of like inside a larger range. So while this used to be the range that we were talking about between $42,000 and $52,000, if this adds this kind of like local range to it, right? So the current range now for the psychological anchors that people will be looking at is actually spreading between 39,000s and 52,000s. Okay, so this large range just got even bigger. So we have already triple range situation. We have range on the weekly, we have range as in the, well, quote unquote head and shoulders pattern that is not a head and shoulders pattern, right? And this median time frame sideways that has kind of like already proven wrong, you know, the range floor at $40,000. Even if you go deeper on lower time frames, then you see another kind of like portion of ranging, just like I said, right? So we have the quadruple range situation, and each and every single range means indecision, the market taking time to make, to generate some sort of like a directional consensus. And here, everybody, it actually shows complete lack of indecision. As of the start of January 2022, right, we are moving literally in a perfect sideways range bound, right? Okay, and the range, just like any other chart pattern, would simply imply that the price action continues in moving inside the range bound between the extremes, the extreme anchor high and the extreme anchor low. Keep doing that, you know, unless you see a proper breakout on either side. And this breakout, this directional breakout, validates a trend thesis, right? We break out of the sideways, which is indecision, non-directional movement, and start trending in certain environment, provided that the breakout is followed by a successful retest, right? So whichever direction it happens, whichever direction it actually unfolds to, you would want to look and search for a proper breakout retest, okay? Breakout retest. And this retest, the success of this retest, is actually what validates the trend. Okay, so in case you see failed failed retest, as in the breakout followed by a breach back beneath the range, and then this is a fake out. This is a fake breakout, specialist breakout, no matter how you call that, right? Similarly, when you see a breakdown here beneath the range lows, and you see the market disrespecting the range floor, acting as a polarity change principle, then acting as a resistance, then failure of the market to play the resistance here is actually what breaches the range back beneath, and we end up getting a larger range, right? Just like I mentioned here in this bottom context. Well, the most important part for you to understand is that whatever happens right now, we are moving in the range defined by an average volatility, right? So you have two kind of like ways to measure the average volatility, on the more conservative side and on the more aggressive side, as in the extreme side. So we are moving per the BPRO bands, per the momentum bands, which are defined again by the variations over the standard deviations. This tells you and implies the short-term average volatility, and hence the biggest chances of Bitcoin to find for you to find trading within these areas, right? So there are highest chances that apparently short-term Bitcoin is supposed to be found trade, between the 41,500s and 44,600s. Approximately, right? So this is the most likely zone that you are supposed to see Bitcoin trade within in the most probable scenario. But you need to also understand that there are the extremes, as in the high extreme and the low extreme. So in case things go extreme, you are supposed to see some higher volatility. Then the higher volatility comes with closing either outside here or at least within the extreme zone, right? So the extreme zone, which is defined by, by the demand volatility, demand and supply, defined by the volatility again, right? So this area between the more conservative and external band, of the high band of the BPRO, this tells you where you can locate the supply based on the volatility, and rather risk to reward ratio not really favoring longs in here. And conversely, when you find Bitcoin trade between the more conservative and more extreme volatility way per the low band of BPRO, then it is basically not really a good risk reward to short this area, right? So you want to be shorting, if anything, right? I'm not a big fan of shorts, but if you are to short, then this is your shorting area and this is your longing area, if anything. Until proven wrong, right? Until proven wrong, as in you see a strong close outside the bands. If you see abnormal volatility, as in strong close outside the bands, right? This is what validates the directional breakout. If you see a strong close above or through the high band of the BPRO, then this lays out a pretty likely scenario for further upside continuation, and then into levels defined by level lines, which I displayed in a second. And on the other hand, again, if you see a proper breach beneath or through the low band of BPRO volatility, then it actually is what validates the downside implications, right? So if you want to go and see what levels are automatically kind of like given by the BPRO level lines, then if we turn on this this aspect here, and it's going to display the main resistances. And for the 4 hour, for the medium time frame, the main resistances are as follows: are 45,566, which is basically pretty near the volatility high. So I wouldn't necessarily want to long this. Perhaps I would want to see Bitcoin breach through this level clearly to acknowledge the breakout. Then another resistance, 49,727, 52,063. Right? If we go to lower time frames, this is also confirmed with the level lines support at 42,403, that if breached may bring 41,073. That's all. Stay safe. God bless and enjoy.